drive in the van.
Yeah, we walk by him right up here.
I'm not going to ask him for it. Cut down yet?
$6.
Yeah.
West Virginia.
featured portal is Sarah Kerr from Pinch, West Virginia. Jenna Molesky from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Holly Siders from Charleston, West Virginia. And Laura Hanna, also from Charleston, West Virginia. Composed of members of the Air Force ROTC unit at West Virginia University. Now, would you please stand for the playing of our national anthem? The national anthem will be conducted today by Don Wilcox, who's presently serving his 30th year as director of bands at WVU. Now, please join us as we honor America. Thank you. guys, all of his four-year band seniors. These seniors have given their time and talent to help make the WVU band a better marching and musical organization. The combined efforts of these individuals over their 4 years add up to hundreds of hours of timely service to the WVU band. At this time, we would ask all four-year band seniors to please step up and be recognized for their dedication to the Mountaineer Marching Band. Also at this time, West Virginia University would like all WVU seniors and their families in attendance to stand and be recognized by everyone for your achievements and hard work over the past year. We all would like to wish you the very best upon your graduation. Number 7, David Carter. from Newville, Pennsylvania, number 69, Rick Gillian. The kicker from Newark, Delaware, number 26, John Holliger. A wide receiver from Miami, Florida, number 80, Carlos Arteaga. A fullback from Rawlings, Maryland, number 40, Royce Howard. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, number 41, Captain Chris Edmonds. A wide receiver from Boca Raton, Florida, number 8, Captain Corey Ivey.
Thomas Herrick as the 2000 most loyal alumni of the year.
Congratulations. The designation of the Loyal West Virginia is given to persons who exemplify faithfulness to the ideals and goals of the state of West Virginia through business, professional, and civic achievements, as well as support of WVU. The most loyal West Virginians for 2000 are Lyle Buffington Clay and Jean Carl Cullen. Mr. Clay has been a lifelong financial supporter of WVU, with special emphasis on the College of Business and Economics and the Creative Arts Music Extension Program. Lyle, along with his brother Hunter, established the Clay Foundation Incorporated in 1987. The Clay Foundation has been a very strong supporter of the Kanawha Valley. One of the most recent focuses has been the new Charleston Arts and Sciences Center, now called the Clay Center for the Arts, which will house the Sunrise Museum, a performance hall for the WVU Symphony Orchestra, and a planetarium and a movie theater. The second recipient of the Most Loyal West Virginian Award is C. Carl Tully, Sr. Dr. Tully received a B.S. from West Virginia University School of Medicine in 1945, and has supported WVU, especially the WVU Medical School, in many ways. Dr. Tully was a director and a member of the Executive Committee of the First National Bank of South Charleston, who remains active in civic community affairs. He was named Citizen of the Year for South Charleston in 1956-57. Dr. Tully has three grown children. Presenting this year's most loyal West Virginia Award was Mr. Duke Perry, President of the WVU Foundation. Congratulations to Lyle Buffington Clay and C. Carl Tully. The next award being presented this afternoon is for the most loyal faculty and staff of the year. Each year it's awarded to an individual who returned or retired members of faculty and staff at WVU and has shown loyalty and faithfulness to leadership and service to the institution. Mr. Paul Martinelli of Morgantown is the 2000 most loyal faculty and staff of the year. Mr. Martinelli has served WVU for more than 30 years. His beliefs and advocacy for the students who make WVU so successful speak highly of his devoted dedication to commitment and commitment to WVU in the state of West Virginia. His education and public contribution extend far beyond the typical campus and classroom setting. He served the university system of West Virginia in many capabilities. Mr. Martinelli was elected the first representative WVU as well as the first classified staff employee and was chair of the Board of Trustees Advisory Council of Classified Employees in 1993. Today, WVU says thank you for your years of loyal and dedicated service. Aaron Chittick, chairman of Mountaineer Week, is now presenting Mr. Martinelli with his award. Congratulations to all of our distinguished winners. University is proud to present the 2000 edition of the Mountaineer Marching Band and their final marching performance of this regular football season. The band would like to open their part of this afternoon's halftime show with a selection celebrating WVU's annual Mountaineer Week, arranged for the Mountaineer Marching Band by WVU music professor Dr. James Miltenberger. Here is the fun-filled Mountain Music Medley. Thank you. present the History of Biz Mountaineer Award. As you know, each year during Mountaineer Week, outstanding seniors are honored for their accomplishments and service to WVU. This year, 10 spectacular seniors have been chosen as finalists. This year, the finalists for 2000 Biz Mountaineer are Meg Daly, escorted by her mother, Jill Daly, and sponsored by Kappa Kappa Gamma. Courtney Flynn, escorted by her parents, Joseph and Stacy Flynn, and sponsored by WVU's Ocean 4-8. Betsy Baird is sponsored by the Street Society of Health System Promises, and escorted by her parents, Ron and Susan Baird. Andrea Ramazan, sponsored by Delta Sigma Phi, is escorted by her parents, Dave and Jeanette Ramazan. Richard Schaefer is sponsored by the WVU Department of Speech Pathology and Audiology and the National Student Speech Language Hearing Association, and escorted by her parents, David and Linda Schaefer. The candidates for the 2000 Wisdom Mountaineer are Thomas Paranassis, escorted by Nick and Joanne Evans, sponsored by Student Athlete Advisory Council. Christopher Graver, sponsored by Golden Key Financial Honor Society, escorted by his parents, David Graver and Roberta Graver. Brian Lee Hagan, sponsored by the National Student Speech Language Hearing Association, escorted by his parents, Gerald and Karen Hagan. Peter Love, escorted by his parents, Charles and Sally Love, sponsored by the WVU Emory College of Business and Economics. David Worker, sponsored by Phi Sigma Kappa, and the Polar Bear Club, escorted by his parents, Gary and Cheryl Workman. And finally, the 1999 Victory of Biz Mountaineer, Douglas Camp and Carrie Beth Law. Flowers for the contestants have been donated by Morgantown, Florence, and the statues provided by the WVU Mountaineer. President and Mrs. Hardesty will present the 2000 Mr. and Ms. Mountaineer Award. They're joined by Carrie Hewitt, the 2000 Mr. and Ms. Mountaineer Committee Chairperson. come to you then, or ask to check out our website address at www.themarchingpride.org. Recordings of the WVU band may be found at www.wvucreativeproductions.com. The WVU band would like to invite you to attend one of the upcoming annual end of the season keynote concerts sponsored by the McGee Foundation. The concert will be held very soon on Monday and Tuesday, November 27 and 28 at the WVU Creative Arts Center. Mountaineer fans, please direct your attention to the MSN Stadium Vision as we pay special tribute to Coach Don Nealon and his 21 years at West Virginia University.
I think Coach Don Nealon comes on the scene from Michigan. He surrounded himself with a very comfortable staff. The staff is just as enthusiastic about the coming men and ladies season as the ball club. Everything is in the past tense of West Virginia from now on. We're concerned about the present. We want to play next year. They have been a losing football team. They've had a losing attitude. They no longer have a losing attitude. These kids know what it takes to win, and we're going to win next year.
Thank you. Another pair of socks.
Giving a round of applause for Swayze.